October, everyone! Thanks for stopping by and checking out another one of my videos. Today, I'm so excited to show you this video. We are going to be making Halloween Treat Pails. These are extremely simple to make, very inexpensive, and they're a fun gift to give to anybody. This month, I am a guest designer at scrapbooking.com, and my featured article is this Halloween Treat Pail. So go ahead and check out my blog. There's a link there that will link you to my article at scrapbooking.com for a complete guideline of the products that you need, as well as instructions and a free spider template. So go over there and check it out. First off, you're going to be needing a Halloween Treat Pail. For this video, I'm using a small black one that I found at Target in the dollar bin. You will need adhesive. You will need Scott's foam mounting tape adhesive, a glue gun, as well as a Xyron. I recommend using a Xyron for this project. You also need candy of your choice, and I'm using Hershey Kisses. You need a treat bag to fill. You can use clear like I have here. You can use decorative ones like I did on my original one that's posted in my article. Whatever you choose. You will also need 12 inches of ribbon. You will need your choice of glitter. Today I'm going to be making a purple spider, so I'm going to be using purple glitter. If you're going to be making a black spider like I did in my article, make sure to use black glitter with black cardstock and purple cardstock with purple glitter. You get the idea. Also, if you want to make the spider that's shown here on the green pail, you will need a Cricut as well as the Doodle Charms Cricut cartridge. You will need to use your blackout key with the spider at 4 inches. If you do not own a Cricut or you do not own this Cricut cartridge, don't worry about it, because I have a free template for you of a hand-drawn spider that you will just need to print out from scrapbooking.com, print it off on your printer, and enlarge it to 4 inches. And this is what that cute little spider will look like. Also, you will need pinking shears if you have those, regular scissors to trim the bottom of your ribbon, and I believe that's it. So I'm going to show you how quick and easy this Halloween Treat Pail is to make. I went ahead and pre-cut my spider at 4 inches using my Doodle Charms Cricut cartridge and the blackout key. And now I'm going to run it through my Xyron. This is a pretty old Xyron. I've had it for years, but it still works great and I love it. I'm going to run that through there. I'm going to trim it off and put that aside. I always like to press down on the clear cover here that you remove just to make sure that I have a full coverage of adhesive, and peel off that film layer. And you're left with your spider here. I'm going to take, you can either use a powder pal or you can use just a scrap piece of paper, and for this video I'm just going to use a scrap piece of paper to lay my spider on. And what I'm going to do next is I'm going to pour my glitter out onto my scratch piece of paper. So what you're going to do is you're going to dip your spider, press it down into the glitter, adhesive side down. I like to do it this way because it gives me a full coverage. I'm in control of where the glitter is going. And then you can shake off your spider. Make sure you got glitter everywhere it needs to be. And that looks good. You can give it another quick pat into the glitter. All right, once that's done, it's time to adhere our little wiggly eyes. You need to apply these with glue gun. I find that the hot glue sticks better to the glitter than just using an adhesive, like zip dry or anything like that. So I'm going to go ahead and put some glue on here. I'm going to put that right up here at the top of my spider. And then I'm going to put the other one on. It's such a quick and easy project. Alright, so now I'm going to cut a small piece of the foam tape. So you're going to apply the Scott's 3M tape to the back of your spider, just right down the center. And you're going to center the spider on the treat pail. For video purpose, I went ahead and pre-filled my candy bag with some candy already. And I've put a bow around with my ribbon, and I'm using a little spider webs ribbon here to go along with my spider. I took my pinking shears and I trimmed off the excess bag. That way my handle can go up. And there you go, a quick and easy Halloween treat to give to somebody special. That's very inexpensive and just fun to make. Thanks for stopping by and checking out my Halloween treat pails. Check out my blog for more information and the link to find your free template on the spider. Leave me a comment and let me know what you think. Thanks for stopping by.